The 10 Pin Bowling Show is proudly brought to you by Interbowl Australia at interbowl.com.au.
Welcome to a new episode of the 10 Pin Bowling Show. We are on the scenic central coast of New South Wales at Gosford City Bowl for the Interbowl Australia Junior State Challenge. With me on my right, we have Team Northern New South Wales, representatives of that. And on my left, we have Cherbeau and Cameron from Southern New South Wales. We'll start with Northern. You guys bowling as a state team together, you guys know each other's games. How do you guys think you're going to go in this format?
I'm pretty confident because, pretty sure that I'm good.
Fair enough. Mark, the last time you were on the show a few weeks ago, you seemed to throw the ball really well. What was the secret to that, and what do you hope to do today?
Just find a line, stick to it, I suppose. And if it's there again this time, I'll play it again.
Well, excellent. Well, we wish you well. Cherbeau, Cameron, last week it seemed like you guys were finding the way on the lanes. I mean, what do you guys hope to achieve today? Obviously, then try to beat Northern, because as you do. But, what are your team objectives? Have you guys set anything that you hope to achieve?
I just want to get out on the lanes with a lot of confidence today and try my best, as always.
Well, that's pretty good. Cameron, you threw the ball great. Is there anything you want to try different this time that you're bowling than the last time?
I'm just going to play my normal line, and then if it doesn't work, I'm just going to adjust for it.
Fair enough. Upstairs we have Michael and Brendan. They're about to commentate the match. I'll send it up to you.
And welcome to all the viewers of this week's edition of the 10 Pin Bowling Show. It's a very special episode for us. It's show number 200 for you, and we thank you very much for joining us. This week we have a challenge between Northern New South Wales and Southern New South Wales. Mark Toonen is the first bowler up. And welcome Brenton Davey, who joins me in the commentary booth.
Just in time to see the lefty go out there and throw a big strike to open the match.
You gotta love that. Very, very nice shot from the left-hander.
And next up, 17-year-old Cameron Walters from Southern New South Wales holds a 199 league average, high game 279. Very, very tall man. Gets very, very low at the line.
Oh my goodness. First ball out the box is a cold 7-10. Looked like it did enough to get through the pocket and knock over that 7, but just would not go.
From that really deep angle, looked like his angle of entry was just a little bit shallow that time. Maybe just a hair late with the break point. Takes out the strike ball, throws it hard and straight, tries to bounce the 10-pin out.
Hoping for some kind of deflection here, folks, because there is Buckley's and none of getting that one without it.
That's right. I mean, I've picked that up, I think, 6 times in 30 years, so it's a tough one.
I don't think I've ever picked it up. Second offering for Cameron Walters. It's a light pocket. Is that an adjustment of some sort?
Not sure if it's an adjustment. Certainly didn't want to be going lighter in the pocket. I think if anything needed to go a little bit more flush on the first shot. That one I think might have been just, maybe a little bit more speed. Leave what they call the dinner bucket. And that's just a perfect execution of that spare shot.
Great pick up there from Cameron. Just entering the pocket into the 2-5. The ball travelling through and taking out the rest. Mark Toonen now for his second attempt.
Second frame now for Mark. Leaving 6-pin this time.
Good start from Mark. He's been in the pocket twice. Slightly high on the second occasion.
Consolidate his team's lead and needs to go back and make this spare. Going cross lane with the plastic ball this time. Oh dear, that, oh. Yeah, that was just left from the get-go.
Well, the hard case plastic has absolutely no chance here of turning in the mid lane, not with that much lane conditioner in the middle part of the lane. But he's got to put that behind him now.
It seems to be the preferred coaching method these days to have the kids throwing the plastic at everything. I have to say from my own personal point of view, being a bit of a traditionalist, that I don't necessarily go along with that, but that'll probably get me in trouble with the powers that be. Mark Toonen, third frame. Might have just tried to just stuff that in there a little bit. Goes a little bit high.
Oh, and gets the break off the right side wall.
Yes, lucky to break up that split. Leaves just the 4-7. Now definitely needs to make this one, otherwise going to find himself in a big early hole.
Bit of support for the Southern New South Wales team. And makes the spare. Very nice takeaway.
Just the way you want to make that spare. Have no trouble using the plastic ball cross lane, shooting that particular corner. 4-7 for the left-hander, 6-10 for the right-hander, because you don't want to have to be throwing the ball at the gutter and having to try and hook along the gutter. The straighter you can throw up the 4 and the 7 for the lefty, 6 and the 10 for the righty, the better off you'll be. Cameron Walters now.
Getting down nice and low, isn't he, at the shot? At times can be become your undoing.
Gets down very low, but I think, and again, just from a personal observation, looks just a little too bent over at the waist through his release point. The knee bend's really good. Like to see a good knee bend like that from a big man like Cameron, but I think just needs to keep the back a little bit straighter.
Spare time now on the 3-9. The double wood takes it away very, very nicely. And after three frames, folks, it is a one-pin match.
Like the way he shot at this one. Again, with the reactive ball. Ball needs to have the power and the heavy roll in the back end to make sure it doesn't deflect away from the back pin. Just opens you up a little bit of margin for error.
Yeah, it makes it a bit difficult being a right-hand cranker as well, trying to take that double wood away, because you can't leave too much of the left-hand side, but you can't play too much of the right either. It's got to be perfect. Just like that shot there.
Nice shot, that one. Light pocket hit, shreds the rack.
Gets out of the hand at the bottom of the ball and really twists it around.
He certainly catches a fair bit of it, and the ball change here for Mark Toonen. Obviously wasn't entirely happy with the reaction he was getting the first three frames. See what adjustment this is.
Oh, lovely shot. A little bit more straight, a little bit more direct. The ball just pointed up nicely. And wow, didn't a gang tackle that 10.
Five pin just got smacked in the guts right there. Big shot there from Mark Toonen, needed it. And very, very good shot indeed. Good aggressive shot, that one. Not playing for as much hook as he was previously.
He's definitely looked up to amp up the ball speed.
Amped up the ball speed, and he's finished his five frames really, really strong.
Yeah, very, very nice shot there. I think you hit the nail on the head before, Brenton, when you said he was looking for a little bit more hook down the outside of the lane. Just wasn't there. So he picked up a different ball and went more direct. Seems to have worked for him.
As I've said many times before, to your chagrin, Michael, sometimes straighter is greater.
Sometimes straighter definitely is greater. I concur. Cameron now to try and add one to his. Oh, that's an unfortunate break. Working off the strike, off the previous frame, and then he gets a ball travel just slightly high. It's enough to leave the 4-9. A very difficult spare, this one.
Needs to basically throw what would be his 7-pin spare shot. Get the ball just to catch the very left-hand edge of the 4-pin. Nah, a little too straight, that one.
Straight there, going for the deflection off the back wall. Unfortunately, was not to be. But he does take one. And here's Dennis with the boys.
I'm right here with Mark Toonen and Cameron Walters from Northern and Southern New South Wales. They just bowled five frames each. Cameron, the lane's playing different than the last time you were here?
Yep, not sure. I just couldn't find my line. Found it once, so I just couldn't hit my spot all the time. It's just not good enough.
Man, what people at home may not realize is how much heart you actually have. You had a major surgery 6-7 months ago, and here you are back on the lines. Man, it's a credit to you. So what exactly happened?
Just over the too much bowling, it just eventually destroyed my scar tissue and my bones started to chip away. So I had to get an operation to clean all that out. So, yeah.
And the goal was to be back for Nationals this year to represent Southern New South Wales. Mate, that's just awesome. It's something that you should be... I know your parents are proud. I was just speaking to them. So that's... Man, it's a credit to you.
Yeah, thank you.
No worries, mate. I'm sure we'll see you in future episodes of this show. Mark, tune in from Northern New South Wales. This is your first year in the team, isn't it?
Yep, it sure is.
Mate, we noticed that... I know Brenton made a comment earlier that you made a ball change. Why'd you do that?
Well, wasn't really hit, like I said, wasn't really hitting as hard, so made a ball change, stick to the same line, and it worked, so.
That it did. It really fired Northern team up. We could see that. So you looking forward to representing Northern New South Wales at the President's Shield?
Certainly am.
It's something else, isn't it?
Yep.
I love bowling.
Your sport has an enormous potential for growth. We urgently need to increase the number of league bowlers who are registered members of Tenpin Bowling Australia, your national sporting organisation. Tenpin Bowling Australia, bowling centre proprietors, centre managers, our champion bowlers and even bowling equipment suppliers are all united and working together to make the sport even better. We need you to play your part and become a registered member now.
If you really love to hit the lanes,
if you really love your sport,
if you really love to bowl with friends,
if you love to feel young,
if you really love bowling like us,
if you really love bowling with family and friends,
if you really want to support your sport,
if you really love your sport, I mean love it, you'll become a registered member now.
But hold on your hats, folks, this is number 12 for the perfect game of 300. He loves it, George Palingos. Not too sure how many he's shot now, but he's shot a perfect game 300 to be the 2009 Melbourne Tenpin Cup champion.
And welcome back to the Tenpin Bowling Show's 200th episode. Coming to you from Gosford City Bowl, New South Wales, covering the Interbowl Australia Junior State Challenge. Cherbeau Webb enters the arena, representing Southern New South Wales. She is 16 years of age, carries a 172 league average and has shot a 279 as her high game. Her first offering turns up just slightly high, going through the nose, leaving the 3-6-10.
Yeah, might have been a little bit tentative on that one first up, trying to make sure that it at least got to the head pin.
I certainly did that. Let's see her spear game form.
Whoa. Look, that almost looked like she lost that one a little bit at the bottom of the swing. Might have rushed it ahead. Now, another left-hander enters the fold. Go the lefties. 13-year-old Emily Rigney. Carries a 170 average and a high game of 245. And this lady doesn't mind revving it up a little bit.
Oh, wow.
There's an aggressive opening shot.
That is sensational. She's had five frames to sit on the bench and get cold, and this is the first offering she brings.
Tell you what, she certainly doesn't leave anything in the back. You look at her through the bottom of the swing there, and she's just... Almost looks like she's got more there than she can handle it.
The ball definitely comes through at a rush, doesn't it, at the bottom of the swing? But, no, that's impressive. Doesn't spend too much time at the approach either.
That one's a little bit inside. Ooh.
Oh, wrong
that
way.
It fell the wrong way, didn't it?
Because that ball really checked up and went through the nose. Hoping for that fall forward, but didn't quite get the job done.
Certainly makes a big, big move in the back end. And, you know, for a 13-year-old, that's especially for a 13-year-old female, and not wanting to sound sexist.
Oh, no, of course not.
Certainly throwing quite a bit of hand.
It is very aggressive, and geez, I like it. It's fantastic, I think.
It is. A lot of girls get up there and feel, and almost a lot of them are coached to throw the ball like a girl. Emily is obviously being coached to throw the ball more like a male. You know, not holding back, not trying to make it sort of look pretty, but she's going all out aggression, and I like to see that. Now, Cherbeau Webb up for her next offering. Coming off an open frame. Much better shot. A lot more positive, a lot more aggressive.
Yeah, she'll be very, very pleased with that one there. She wasn't too sure about the ball holding pocket, but it just got there. Enough oil in the middle of the lane to carry that there. And boy, her team needed that one because they were falling behind.
That's for sure, but we need another one. You know, it's a bit inside too. We
broke up the split, leaves a 6-10. Now, if you remember a couple of frames ago, folks, she did take the 6-10 out of the 3-6-10 combination, so he's hoping she can do that again.
Double bounce that one, lost that one at the bottom of the swing. Can be difficult sometimes, you know, if you're going from one ball to another, your strike ball to another ball to shoot your spares. If they don't feel absolutely the same, if you haven't got the same amount of tape in the thumb hole, etc., can be difficult. Emily Rigney now.
In that instance, I think overreacted with the outside of the lane. But I think she'll take some heart from that because it starts to give her a little bit of area, some playroom to work with. It means she can probably move just a little bit deeper into the inside of the lane and be reasonably confident that she's going to get a good reaction. Good takeaway.
Certainly good spare there. As you notice, that ball actually hooked into where the pocket is. And, you know, she might take something from that, make that adjustment. If she can throw that shot regularly.
Oh, I like this.
Great shot.
Fantastic. Found the outside of the lane. That's exactly what we were talking about last frame.
What are you doing?
Picking at the ball.
Not like that. Look, you place your hands around the ball like this, and you lift the ball with both hands. Then, and only then, you insert your fingers into the holes.
Like this.
Perfecto!
Back to the Interbowl Australia Junior State Challenge. You're back with Cherbeau Webb, who is taking the ninth frame for her team.
And they need to start stringing some strikes. There's a start right there.
Look, previous to this shot, they were 43 pins adrift. And, well, if there are any hope to take this one away, they need some help from Northern New South Wales. Yeah, Cherbeau Webb.
Coming up in the 10th, needs to throw some more strikes. Gave that one some room.
Oh! Hits the pocket light. And carries all 10, how about that?
Hit them thin, watch them spin, and they certainly spun on this shot. Have a look at it. Head pin got over into the left-hand side of the deck there, and got the job done. As I've said many times before, this is why bowlers try to hook the ball. Gives them more angle of entry, allows them to carry the off hits a little bit better. Now, this is putting Southern right back into some kind of connect. Wow, here we go.
Oh, coming home in a flurry here. Two in the 10th, plus one in the 9th. Going to make them bowl for it.
You're certainly going to make Northern turn up in the 10th frame to at least make sure that they throw something half decent. It's certainly been a good finish here by Cherbeau Webb. Shame about a couple of the spare problems.
But no, finished in style, and they were three identical hits, weren't they?
Three very, very good sized, and finishes with a four-bagger.
Southern New South Wales finished with a score of 170.
Even if it's not enough to win, at least it creates a little bit of momentum for your teammates going forward.
Oh, absolutely.
Makes them feel a little bit better about life.
Also gives them a better idea of where the shot is too, so everybody's learning.
Now, it's a winner right there, folks. Emily won't have to go back and shoot the spare, but of course she will.
It's nice when you get up in the 10th and all you have to do is take a decent count in the first ball. But you really want to go out in style here. Pick up the spare and throw a confident shot. But I've been really impressed with what I've seen here with Emily, and not only Emily, Mark before her. They work well as a team.
Yeah, when you've got two left-handers out there, they certainly allows them to work with each other, help each other get lined up.
Absolutely. It's not too often that two lefties get to take to the arena together, break down the lane condition and
exactly
work together for a better shot. See Tristan Foo there in the background. He also is a left-hander, so there's an abundance out there.
That there is. Emily Rigney.
Nice finishing shot there.
And final score, Northern New South Wales 192 defeated Southern New South Wales 170.
Welcome back to the 10 Pin Bowling Show. You just saw a great conclusion to the match between Southern and Northern. Cherbeau, you had four strikes in a row that really showed the Southern pride.
Yeah, well, Southern's are known for our Southern pride, so just thought I'd show some.
If you're in the States, Southern's known for fried chicken, but anyway, you guys are known for pride.
Yeah, pretty much.
Cameron, pretty solid. It looked like the condition changed and you had to really find your way, but you put a good foundation for Cherbeau to finish the game.
Yeah, I did a bit, but still wasn't good enough. That's it to win.
Yeah, mate, I guess you play with what you brought on the day. I thought you guys did very solid. I thought your pride and your team showed through. Emily, Mark, again, you guys bowled well. Mark, as we discussed earlier, you made that ball change. It seemed to be a critical difference. And Emily, you seemed a lot more relaxed bowling on television your second time over your first time.
Yeah, definitely.
So, how was the lanes reading for you? Did you have to make many adjustments?
Not really, but probably should have, but didn't. But the pins I did leave behind, they were easy to spare, so that really helped.
That's something that all of us bowlers at home can learn too, that you really didn't worry about the first shot as much as making sure you took care of your spares. That's something many coaches try to teach their athletes, so well done. And that'll see the conclusion of this week's episode of the 10 Pin Bowling Show. Please join us again next week for the continuing coverage of the Interbowl Australia State Junior Challenge. Thank you and good night.
The 10 Pin Bowling Show was proudly brought to you by Interbowl Australia at interbowl.com.au.